Up next on Transformers and Stuff, TRNS-EX1, 2010 exclusive TFCON Toronto Nightbird. Hello everybody, welcome to another Transformers and Stuff review. I'm Atrod ISR, and this is Nightbird, TFCon exclusive, in the box. This figure is not new, I mean, it didn't just came out, as you know, as you understood, 2010 exclusive, but why am I reviewing it now? Because it just got out on sale on most of the popular sellers. This one I got from TFsource for $30, and this is why I decided to review it, because it's a good price for a third company product, and I'll talk about all the good things about this figure and the bad things. Just from the start, the box. It's a very cool G1 styled box with all the purple and black, and the figure here, and the color. I'm sorry, and the window here that you can see the figure in its vehicle mode. Of course, all the letters, all the markings are to resemble the G1 box. We have TFCon on the above here. On the front, as I said before, the figure. The TRNS-EX1 Transitional Neural Robot Soldier by impossibletoys. On the side, just like in the G1 box, the figure and the vehicle mode. The other side again. On the bottom, impossibletoys.com. Set includes blah blah blah, made in Macau. And on the back is stats and an art showing other variations of the mold, RC, Quintessons and Quintesson Guard, and another repaint of this mold. I don't remember her name, but I'm sure a lot of you out there do. So we'll take it out of the box and see what we got. So we took Nightbird and all its accessories out of the box. You've got the instruction sheet, you got a little baggie with her two handguns and two clips to clip her size to her forearms, and her lightsaber. The lightsaber and size are stored here on the bubble, and of course Nightbird inside. We'll just take everything to the side and focus on Nightbird. So, just a quick size comparison. This is Nightbird in her vehicle form. And here she is next to our lovely cup from the, I believe it was Hunt for the Decepticons line, or one of those. So, Nightbird is a Scout class figure, at least in her vehicle form. The car itself has four wheels. They roll, but one of them is a bit stuck, so she doesn't roll perfectly, but on some surfaces she will move. No, the vehicle mode itself is the same mode that Impossible Toys used for RC, as you all know. The nice thing here is you get a Nightbird that also transforms. That's the bonus for me. The colors are very Nightbird-y. I love the purple here on the seats and the translucent windshield. The gray itself is a bit dull, and that also shows all the defects in the mold itself. Here you can see all the stripes here and paint splash, and here the gaps in the plastic parts. This fin is made of pretty hard plastic. I will be careful with that. Very pointy. The finish here is not perfect. You cannot close this all the way down, because then her head will pop out and then it will not stand flush on the on your table or on your shelf. The paint apps themselves are pretty good. Like I said, a little minor splash here. The plastic quality looks semi cheap. It doesn't feel very cheap, but it looks pretty amateur. All in all, you should remember that this is TFCON exclusive, so most of these are usually in a very limited production, and so you should take care of it as it was a rarity and not a regular toy, so you should not be handling it too much. On the back, on the bottom, you see all the robot parts, the head, hands, legs, crotch. So all in all, again, the vehicle mode is pretty nice, and continuing with the robot mode, and here we have Nightbird in her robot mode. She's a very hard robot to stand because of her little feet and the fact that she has a pretty heavy backpack. But if you take a couple of seconds, you will get her to stand. Now, just before we continue, a quick size comparison. Here he is. My Prime Starscream next to her, as you can see here. She's a bit taller than a Scout Class, but she's definitely not a Deluxe. So that's her next to him. But she's not supposed to be too big, so I'm guessing she will do fine next to your other Transformers. Now, let's take a close look at what we've got here. So her face. Her face are pretty good. Nice colors, the purple and the yellow eyes. It does resemble her G1 cartoon self. Of course, her body is the RC mold, so it will not be as she was in the cartoon. But again, the colors are pretty matching. The black knees, black feet, crotch area, and here the purple again. Very similar to her cartoon self. Forearms again black, and all the rest is that dull gray we saw on the car mode. The plastic here again, quality is not the best. I mean, the edges are very squeaky and very fragile. Please handle with care. Some of the edges here are somewhat loose, although articulation is very good. She has 360 ball joint shoulder, in and out, swivel at the biceps, and the double hinged elbow. No wrist movement, no waist movement. Head does not move. Her legs, again, 360 ball joint, in and out. No swivels. She has an hinge in her knee, and her feet move up and down due to transformation. I will not put her weapons on her, because a friend of mine who got this figure too said the minute he tried to put one of her weapons inside here on her fist, I think he said it broke or it did not even fit in. And when he tried to put the clip on her forearm, the side broke. I don't know. Like I said, I'm not gonna try here on camera. Just believe me, it's a pretty cool figure all in all. Again, for $30, I can recommend this. Again, it's for a hardcore collector or someone who really wants a Nightbird. There are a few more Nightbirds out there. And I think this one gets you a bonus because she transforms. Again, all in all, she looks pretty cool. It's not a kid's toy. It's a nice collector's item. Again, you get nice accessories with her, her weapons, a nice box. And that's it, folks. Please, don't be shy, comment, subscribe, see you in my next review.